He said deception is there. Yesterday I was passing by one of the families and the mother said to me, Sayyidina, the problem in what we are facing, us and our children, a lot of gray areas in life. We don't know this right or wrong. We can't convince our children that this is wrong. What can we do? Deception. We don't know the truth. Jesus asked it. Jesus said to Pilate in the cross, he said to him, you know that you should know the truth. I will tell you the truth. Do we need the truth? Do we need to put bounds to our life? Jesus said at the end of this sermon, he said, what I say to you, I say to everyone, be watchful. Feel watchful. What's the meaning of watchful? Be alert. Deception. But I know my God. I ask my God, put me boundaries. Tell me the truth, Lord. I like very much. Always I like to share with my fathers in Africa, Psalm 139. When David said, Lord, examine me, examine my behavior, examine, let your spirit examine every part in me. And when you find something wrong, tell me, Lord, punish me. Do you have this prayer? Do you want to know the truth? Or you like to be compromising? Deception is there. Are you brave to say, no, I don't want to displease my God? Are you strong to say, like Joseph, I can't do this great sin and I break the heart of my Savior, my Jesus. I love him. I want him to be happy. I want to honor him. Easy to do this sin and say this is fun or this is life. But I don't want that. Are we brave? Are we spiritual? I was sharing with group in the evening. Are we sitting enough with the Lord that the truth of the Lord is inside us? Because the Lord promised us in the epistle to John, that you have anointment inside you. You have something. You have voice. You have presence of God, which tell you the truth. Do we have that? Or because most of our life in the world now, we take the color of the world. We have saying in Africa, yeah, when a person is like compromising, they call him chameleon. You know chameleon? That he took the color of everything. When it is green, he is green. When it is red, he is red. On Sunday, he is very spiritual. He's crying. He's repenting. You look at him like he is Saint Beeman, who is worried about him today. And Monday, you find another person. The same person, but behaving another thing. What's that? Yes. We need to repent. We need to be watchful. We need to know that we will meet Jesus. Saint Peter said, you are the children of God. Shouldn't be when Jesus comes back or you go to meet him to be in a holy conduct, holy life? Or what's the shape of your life? When I will meet Jesus and say, give account about your life, what can I say to him? Will I say, Lord, you know how much I love you? How much I honor you? How much I was caring for your name. How much I kept this body holy for you, a temple for the Holy Spirit. How much I give you priority in my time, in my body, in my talents. Or we were so distracted and busy. We forgot the Lord. You remember the Lord always or not? I fear some people remember the Lord on Sunday only. But the rest of the week, they are like distracted. It's a lot of things. Let us today, it is end of the Coptic year and beginning of the new year. Are we willing to enter the new year with the same personality, character, or are we willing to be changed? It is up to us. You want to be changed or not? To be the same? And to have the same excuses? And the same... Is that sad? Always I say it to people, you can say this excuse for me. Can you say it to God? Always they do like that. When they say, look, Sayyidina, listen, Sayyidina, I will tell you why. I said, okay, I agree. I accept what you said. But if you would say that to God, will God agree? Always say no. Are we ready? Are we watchful? How about our salvation? Is that priority or not? Is that priority or not? I want to tell you last story before I end. It happened with me when I was young and young priest in South Africa serving there. We have one of the church member. His wife was an angel, but the man was far away from the Lord. And he has big business in liquor and like that. Never come to the church. And it came a week, I felt God is disturbing me about this man. I can't, all the time I want to skip, I don't have time. The Lord reminding me I should visit him. At the end, I went home to him. I opened Bible, I speak about Bible, and the man was welcoming us and offer us food and like that. I said, how long you didn't come to the church? I asked him this question. He said, oh, you know that my business work Sunday. How can I come to the church? I said, but man, that time I like to pray every day a liturgy. I said, man, I can pray for you liturgy in the middle of the week. He said, no, it's hard for me. And I said, look, let us agree. When you want to pray, when you want that I pray for you liturgy. He was so much like frustrated when I insist. He said, okay, tomorrow I can come to the church. I said, what time? I will not make the offering till you come. Because in the start, he said, I can't get up early morning. I said, I will wait for you. What time? He said, it's okay. 9:00. I said, okay. I'm waiting for you. 9:00. Till you come, we'll praise the liturgy. I kept waiting. 9:30, 10. He didn't come. I pray a liturgy. At the end, I find a lot of missed calls in my mobile from the wife. And I called her. I said, where is he? And she said, he was shot yesterday evening and transferred to the hospital. Please go and see him. Please try to save him. And I went to the hospital. And he was between like semi-coma. He looked at me and said, please care for my wife and the children. And enter coma. And he passed away. And we prepare for the funeral because the wife was helpless. We did everything for her. But during the prayer of the funeral, I promise you, I swear in front of the Lord, I was knocking over his coffin like that. I say, you are foolish man. Are you foolish or not? God gave you last chance to be ready to meet him and you lost it. You are foolish or not? And I was crying, not sadness, but sadness upon the salvation of the man, that the Lord gave him last chance to be saved and he rejected it. And now he is dead. He took nothing. He was caring for money and business and don't have time. I'm so much busy. I'm businessman. And at the end, he took nothing. He was helpless. Dead body. And now he should meet the Lord to give account about his life. What would he say? When the Lord said to him, I send you my son to help you. And even though you reject it. What can he say to the Lord? Be careful. It is time to be awakened. It is time to search for our salvation. It is time when I come, I find my king is opening his arms for me, want to save me, and want to give me his life, his new life. Why not use it? I'm always saying, why not to use all the promises of the Lord against the Lord? I say, you promise, I'm coming to you. I need you, Lord. I need your salvation. And God will give you forgiveness. God will give you new life. God will give you power. God will give you everything. God in the church has everything for you, that you live the holy life. St. Peter said that. He gave us everything to keep us holy. But are we willing to be blessed, holy, or we want to be always down and sad and broken? Today is a chance. I don't think it is wise to enter the new year with the same personality, with the same weakness. Today it is, forget, but God bless the Father. You will enjoy the prayer of the Father. Forget my voice or whatsoever. Like in, today, shall we be serious, kida, and close our eyes during the time of the liturgy and say, Lord, today I want to touch you. I want to be healed. I want to have new power, new vision. I want to change my conscience. I want to change me from inside. I want to go back home blessed. I want to carry this burden of all my sins. And I think the fathers agree with me that God wants to offer salvation, healing, and forgiveness of sin to everyone in the church. Do you believe that or not? God is God of forgiveness. He likes to forgive. Shall we be serious today? I say, today even. Today God gave me last chance to be ready that I enter the new year as a new person. Shall we use that chance and close our eyes and be serious and say, Lord, I'm a sinner. Lord, I'm a sinner. I'm coming. I'm weak. I'm down. I'm not pleasing you. Save me, Lord. Save me, Lord. Heal me, Lord. I promise the Lord would heal you. And you will go back home, different, blessed person, shining person. Because Jesus said, when you find all this, know that I'm coming. I'm coming to help you. I'm coming to bless you. Do you believe that Jesus in the church or not? Want to hear your prayers or not? Want to change you or not? Have power for you or not? Let us close our eyes for a moment now before we start. Can we close our eyes for a moment? Can we say to the Lord, Lord, I need you. Please close your eyes. Please pray in your heart and say, Lord, enough, what happened? I don't want to continue this weak life again. Enough, Lord. Today is the day of salvation, of healing. You are here. You are knocking the door of my heart. You want to bless me. You want to bless me. I don't want to miss the blessing, Lord, today. I will not be always sad down, Lord. Today is the day of joy, of salvation, of healing. Thank you, Lord, because today you give us another chance to be saved. Thank you, we are in the place of blessing, power of saints, of angels. And your body and blood is here, Lord, to give eternal life to everyone. And your arms are open to accept everyone. You are willing to forgive any sin whatsoever we did in the past. Your blood, Lord, is more than sufficient to wash every sin. To give every single one of us today, Lord, a new life, a new character, a new mind, a new body, to make everything new. Your spirit is here, Lord, to renew us, to revive us, Lord, to change us, to bless us. We are submitting ourselves to you. We confess we are sinners. We are weak. We are down, Lord. We don't have any excuse except one thing, that we are coming to your love. We are coming to your salvation, to the power of the Spirit inside to save and heal us. That all of us can enter the new year with joy, with blessing, with power. We thank you, Lord, for that beautiful liturgy today. Beautiful love. Bless all of us. We are praying for the church, for Sayyidina al-Baba, all the bishop metropolitans. We are praying to my fathers here in the church. We are praying that everyone in need, Lord, in problem, in sickness, to bless them. So the Shah Mother Virgin Mary and Archangel, all the saints, hear us praying to you, our Father who art in heaven. Hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom. Amen. Thank you.